Hey Leute, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles hier bei The Great Ace Attorney 2. Im letzten Part hat Richter Higoku die gesamte Tat gestanden, dass er Gregson umgebracht hat. Und dann sollte Van Sieks eigentlich freigesprochen werden von Strongheart. Aber Kazuma hat einen Einspruch erhoben und deswegen geht es noch weiter, weil Kazuma behauptet hat, dass Van Sieks eben immer noch der Reaper ist und dass er hinter allem steckt, dass er das Mastermind hinter allem ist. Van Sieks hat eine Aussage dazu abgegeben, wo er jetzt behauptet, dass es keine gemeinsame Verbindung gibt zwischen ihm, Gregson und Dr. Wilson. Zwischen ihm und Gregson gibt es schon eine Verbindung natürlich, aber nicht zwischen ihm und Wilson, sagt er. Und leider lügt er hier, denn doch, die gibt es. Das wird er verheimlichen. Und das müssen wir jetzt aufzeigen. Das würde sonst Kazuma wahrscheinlich eh auch aufzeigen und wir machen das mal zuvor schon, auch wenn das nicht gut ist vielleicht für uns. Aber ja, auf jeden Fall, der Autopsiebericht von Clint, vom Bruder von Van Sieks, der ihm sehr am Herzen lag, der wurde ja durchgeführt von John H. Wilson und deswegen ist da die Verbindung. Ja.
Objection!
Objection! What is this? An autopsy report. Wait. This is 10 years old, from the autopsy of Lord Clint Van Sieks. What? My brother's autopsy report. I'm pleased to see the defense doesn't intend to run from the undeniable truth. Order in court. What reason do you have for presenting a 10-year-old autopsy report here, counsel? This, the autopsy report of the professor's final victim, is an indelible link between Inspector Gregson, Dr. Wilson, and the defendants. Not that accursed name again, the professor. I've personally researched all of the court records relating to that case. I know that at the time, autopsy was considered sacrilege to the victim's souls, and for a member of the aristocracy like Lord Clint Van Sieks, it was unthinkable. But someone implored the powers that be to allow the autopsy to go ahead, Inspector Gregson. He declared that he was certain he would obtain conclusive proof from the procedure. And it was Dr. Wilson who conducted the autopsy. His signature is clearly visible on the document. As promised by Gregson, the autopsy did indeed produce evidence. Evidence that conclusively proved Genshin Azugi was guilty of the murders. In my brother's dying moments, he mustered all his remaining strength to leave that vital clue behind. Was war das für ein Beweis? Das wissen wir immer noch nicht, ne? Was das für ein Beweis war. Der wurde, glaube ich, im Magen gefunden von Clint und hat dann eben auf den Professor hingedeutet. Aber was war das für einer? Indeed, that was the key to indicting the professor for his crimes and the conclusive evidence that convicted him. It enabled Lord Van Sieks here to avenge his brother's senseless death with a marvelous victory in court. A marvelous victory, was it? I wonder if that's really true. What? Could the same be said if it turned out that the key piece of evidence in question was in fact fabricated? And if the inspector, the coroner and the prosecutor all colluded together to cast an innocent Japanese man as a mass murderer and send him to his death. That's outrageous. And now, 10 years later, for some reason the secret has been threatened and needs protecting. Which is why the inspector and the coroner have to be silenced, isn't it? By someone in power in Japan and in Britain, using the two killers recruited for the assassin exchange. Order, order at once! 10 years ago, my father was convicted in this very courtroom as a mass murderer, to be sentenced to death. But it was all a sham, and I swore to myself that I'd prove it. Which is why I had to come to Britain. Whatever the cost!
Das habe ich ja auch schon mal vermutet. Ich glaube auch sogar, dass der Professor, also dass der Vater von Kazuma nicht dieser Massenmörder ist. Ich glaube, jemand anderes steckt da dahinter. Und es kann sein, dass es ihm nur in die Schuhe geschoben wurde. Vielleicht steckt da auch Strongheart dahinter. Hinter allem, ich weiß es nicht.
You'll have to forgive me if I feel compelled to toast this vengeful Nipponese's tenacity of purpose here. However. He who fails to crush his emotions in the courtroom has failed as a lawyer.
come on, Kazuma. You know this won't wash. You're claiming your father was misrepresented in a trial that took place a whole decade ago? You must see that without evidence, that's nothing more than a wild accusation. As it happens, I have evidence. What? As the court has heard, I crossed the channel to France with Gregson on the 31st. I went with him on the pretext of being the assassin recruited to kill Seishiro Iroku. But my true intentions were to make the inspector tell me the truth. What truth? The truth about the evidence, and he acknowledged what I'd already deduced. There's a closely guarded secret about what went on in that autopsy 10 years ago. What? A secret? I know nothing of any secrets. While we waited for my supposed mark in Yigoku's cabin, I drew my clan's illustrious sword, Karuma, before the inspector's eyes. He very quickly understood what my true motive was. Right, I see. You're that Azuki's young lad, are you? And what? You're gonna cut me down with that thing, is that it? That will very much depend on the answers you give to my questions. I want to know what really happened 10 years ago. The truth, that's all. Before we get into it, let me make one thing clear. I still believe your father was the professor. There's no doubt in my mind. But unfortunately back then, we didn't have the evidence we needed to make the crime stick. So, you admit it then. The evidence used in my father's trial was fabricated. It was for the good of the country. Anyway, I was just following orders. Orders? What exactly did you do? Speak! I'm not saying another word. Even if your life depends on it. That's right. Even then. Ah. So kam der Schlitz in den Koffer. So that's when the tip of the sword broke. Okay, ich meine, das ist natürlich eine Kacksituation für Kazuma. Ich verstehe schon. Trotzdem ist das auch nicht cool, dass er da jemanden droht zu zerhackstückeln mit dem Schwert, auch wenn er die Wahrheit rausfinden will. Da gibt's andere Methoden.
Oh, Kazuma-sama.
If the results of Clint Van Sieg's autopsy were fabricated, then the investigating officer Gregson and the lead coroner Wilson must have known about it. And they can only have been ordered to pervert the course of justice in that way by one man. The man leading the case for the prosecution, Barrick Van Sieg. In other words, the defendant did have cause to organize this exchange of assassins. Exactly. And as was established earlier, it has to have been the Reaper himself who liaised with Yigoku in Japan to arrange the exchange. So it follows that the Reaper's true identity can only be that of the man who stands accused in this courtroom today, Barrick Van Sieg. Objection! Oder ist es jemand noch mächtigeres, der das auch schaffen könnte? Kazuma Azuki. What? What you've just told the court? Are you absolutely certain of your facts? Did Gregson really fabricate evidence for the trial 10 years ago? I heard it with my own ears. A shameful admission. In that case, I know. The name of the Reaper. What? What Van Sieg? I gave no such orders. I know that for certain. Which narrows down the remaining possibilities to one. If Lord Van Sieg isn't the one behind all this, then yes. There's only one other person who could have done something like that. I believe I know who it is too. You. I just had a feeling this name was going to come up. The true identity of the infamous Reaper of the Bailey is... Die wahre Identität des berühmt-berüchtigten Reaper of the Bailey ist... Okay, ich muss jetzt einfach so zeigen. Ja, ne? Von Anfang an beim ersten Treffen war mir klar, dass... Also nicht klar, aber ich halt, hab's für sehr wahrscheinlich gehalten, dass er der Oberbösewicht sein würde. Ich finde schade, dass er es ist, weil das war halt sowas von obvious. Weil immer mächtige Typen, ultramächtige Typen, die Bösewichte sind in Ace Attorney. Aber ja, Mel Strongheart steckt hinter allem. Take that! The only person who could have arranged the assassin exchange and manipulated the autopsy results. Is the Lord Chief Justice himself, Lord Mel Strongheart. Lord Strongheart? Na, was sagst du? Yes, it's true that 10 years ago the defendant handled the prosecution of the professor in court. But he only took over the case after his brother, Lord Clint von Sieks, had been killed. I can only assume that this is the most inappropriate joke in British judicial history. Well, Lord von Sieks. 10 years ago, I was very new to my profession. But I had a burning desire to avenge my brother's death, so I pleaded for control of the case. The investigation to that point. The supplication of the Lords to allow my brother's corpse to be examined. All the evidence I was given. The autopsy reports. It all came from you. I've spent my life since then believing I was in your debt for the way you stood aside and let me handle the trial. But I see now. I was very much mistaken. It was a hugely influential force that caused the inspector and the coroner to break the law 10 years ago. And that same force was still felt a decade later on the other side of the world by Seishiro Higoku. Lord Strongheart, everything falls into place when we recognize that you are the Reaper of the Bailey. The court awaits your response, my lord. This may very well go down in British judicial history, but I assure you, it is no joke. Consider this a formal accusal by the defense. It doesn't warrant a response. A formal accusal? Don't be absurd. The defense's claims are utter nonsense, a wild fantasy at best. You're not going to defend yourself. You claim there was some wrongdoing with Lord Clint von Sieks' autopsy. That's utterly untrue. Objection. Objection. But I heard it from Gregson's own lips, he admitted to it. And where is your evidence? What? Gregson's dead now. Unless you were thinking of summoning a ghost to the stand. Hätten wir doch nur Maya da. You mean to say... I forget how the system works in your little backwater country, but in the courts of the British Empire, without evidence, there is no case. I have no intention of entertaining some wild fantasy that can possibly be substantiated by anyone or anything. Ugh. Order, order in courts. Following Inspector Gregson's murder and in the light of Dr. Wilson's death as well, there's really no one left who could testify about the events of 10 years ago, is there? So that was the real purpose of the assassin exchange. This court has no business raking over the coals of a case that was concluded a decade ago. The accusal brought by the prosecution and the defense is categorically denied. I take it there are no objections. Kazuma. He's more or less waited his whole life for this moment. Is there really nothing else we can do now? Is there no other avenue we can go down in pursuit of the truth about what happened all those years ago? If only there was someone who could testify about Clint von Sieg's autopsy. Wenn es doch nur jemanden gäbe, der über die Autopsie von Clint von Sieg aussagen könnte. Mikotoba, stimmt. Mikotoba war doch, genau, Mikotoba war, genau. Wir haben ja dadurch herausgefunden, überhaupt das mit dem Vater von Iris und so, kam er da zum ersten Mal dann überhaupt raus, dass Wilson nur die Unterschrift darunter gesetzt hat, aber den ganzen Autopsiebericht geschrieben hat Mikotoba und der war da auch dabei. Und der lebt noch. Deswegen könnten wir ihn fragen. Ja. Es gibt noch jemanden. He's gone to extraordinary length to cover his tracks. Even so far as dispatching an assassin all the way to Japan to ensure Dr. Wilson's silence. And Dr. Scythe won't say anything against Strongheart. But there's still one ray of hope.
Objection!
Objection. Actually, there is one person. One person who could still testify about that autopsy. Don't be ridiculous, there's no one left. Who, Ryunosuke, who? Tell me. Kazuma, I... Please, this trial can't end. Not yet. I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing it for the truth. The person the defense would like to call to the stand to testify about the autopsy of Lord Clint von Sieg is... Die Person, die die Verteidigung gerne in den Zeugenstand rufen wollen würde, um über die Autopsie von Lord Clint von Sieg auszusagen, ist... Mikotoba. Ziemlich sicher.
Take that!
Take that! Heaven help us, another Japanese. An expert in forensic medicine, my lord. Professor Eugene Mikotoba. 16 years ago... Mir fällt übrigens gerade auf, dass ich das J im Namen Yuchin schon wie Ch ausspreche. Wird er doch Chikuku ausgesprochen, der Richter? Habe ich es all die Zeit falsch gemacht? Egal. In meiner Aussprache wird er Higoku ausgesprochen. He came to London with Sashiro Higoku and Genshin Azugi as a visiting student. And what could his testimony possibly tell us? Professor Mikotoba was the primary assistant during the autopsy in question. He was also the person who actually penned the report. Incorrect. The autopsy was carried out by the coroner, Dr. Wilson. The report carries his signature. It was the primary assistant's duty to keep a written record of the coroner's work during the procedure. In actual fact, the coroner merely read over the report at the end and signed it. In other words, Professor Mikotoba witnessed the entire autopsy from start to finish. The defense demands that Professor Mikotoba be summoned as a witness as a matter of urgency. Whatever really happened in that autopsy laboratory 10 years ago is something only he can tell us. The defense's demand is denied. What? But Professor Mikotoba is in London at this very moment. We could summon him to the stand in minutes. No, of course he's not going to agree to it. Strongheart has no intention of summoning anyone who knows. Können wir nicht mal den normalen Richter herholen? Den britischen Richter? He's too concerned about protecting himself. Prosecutor Azugi, let me refresh your memory as you seem to have forgotten the prosecution's stance. Only minutes ago, you accused the defendant of being the Reaper and of masterminding the assassin exchange. I did, yes. So present your evidence for those claims and make your case complete. At this time, I don't have the requisite evidence, but that's exactly why we need witness testimony. The professor case is closed. There are no clues in the distant past that will bolster your argument today. I'm afraid to say, Prosecutor Azugi, that you would appear to be possessed by the spirit of your late homicidal father. Now, as I stated earlier, this court has already reached a conclusion with respect to the matter at hand. Inspector Gregson was murdered by Japanese Supreme Court Judge Seishiro Higoku. As for any hidden circumstances that may exist, they will be investigated in due course by the proper authorities.
Objection!
Objection. But we all know what will happen. That'll just give the mastermind of the whole venture time to cover his tracks again. By which you mean me. Your punishment for this contemptible behavior will be decided at a later date. As for you, Prosecutor Asugi, you will be remanded following these proceedings. Willingly, I trust, since you gave your word. This futile game of revenge is over, young Master Asugi. Irgendjemand. That will be all. I hereby declare this trial to be over. Hold it! Sehr schön. Wer war das? Sholmes! Zur Rettung! Mr. Sholmes? This is no place for amateur detection, Mr. Sholmes. May I remind you that these proceedings are closed to the general public. You will leave the courtroom at once.
Objection!
Mr. Sholmes was instrumental in the apprehension of Seishiro Yigoku before he fled from Europe. The court should hear what he has to say. Lord May Strongheart, it's imperative that you refrain from bringing this trial to an end at this stage. Is it really? And why would that be? You need only recall your own words from the opening of the trial to answer the question, if I may. We will stop at nothing to uncover the whole truth behind these disturbing findings. Surely it can't be. That the shock of being accused of being the Reaper yourself has erased it from your memory, can it? The whole truth, sir, has already been uncovered. It would seem that we have a great many important members of the judiciary present here today. I put it to you, my dear fellows, should the trial end at this juncture? After all, why have you been invited to attend, to nod along to the prevarications of your superiors? Order, order in court! It seems to me that we stand before a door that leads to a new era of legal practices. A door that is ajar, oder so. Let us emerge from the shadows of the Reaper's decade-long ascendancy. For you and you alone, my dear fellows, have the power to push this door open now. The auditors in the gallery have no rights to express an opinion on court proceedings. Silence!
He's right. The judge has absolutely authority here. Yes, if he calls the trial to an end, it must end. But will that really do? I sense dark things occurring behind the scenes. Dark things indeed.
Is there a single person here present who can honestly...
Das ging ja viel zu schnell.
What's?
The trial should go on. Summon the witness. That's right. We need to clear this up before that young Japanese fellow is... irgendwas.
My lord, you assured those present that you would uncover the whole truth there. Vindicate yourself of this outlandish accusation. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. That's the very foundation of British law.
A toast to my dependable colleagues in the gallery.
On with the trial!
Testify! Well, my lords, you hear the voice of British justice, I take it. I think you'll find it will be rather awkward to silence. The court will recess briefly. I have no intention of shrinking from these allegations. Bailiff, arrange for the subpoena of the witness at once. As soon as the gentleman arrives at the courthouse, we shall reconvene. A recess won't be necessary, my lord.
Doch, gib mir eine Pause, ich brauche wieder Leben.
Pardon. Mikotoba is a close friend of mine. He accompanied me today and is waiting in the antechamber as we speak. I do believe he's been enjoying a little trip down memory lane, in fact.
What? Professor Mikotoba is here in the courthouse?
Mr. Sholmes, you didn't notice what happened, did you? My dear fellow, no one is in a better position to answer that question than you, surely. I wasn't just asking for the fun of it, you know. Well, I must thank you for your assistance in this matter, Mr. Sholmes. Ever. You are of no further use here. Kindly leave the courtroom at once. But of course, in truth, I find myself rather busy now as a result of these developments. Mr. Naruhodo. Yes? I trust you have Iris's little lucky charm with you. Genau, wir können in Kontakt bleiben. Absolutely. It's still in my pocket. She sends her regards and a reminder. If you find yourself at a dead end, the ears are at your disposal. Just one tag, if you please. Oh, of course. In that case, the trial will continue without delay. Bailiff, show the witness to the stand. So it's Lord Strongheart. He's the Reaper of the Bailey. Where exactly is this trial going to take me, I wonder? Just how deep am I about to be plunged into the blackness of the abyss? Well, I'm ready. I'm ready to head into the heart of this maelstrom and confront whatever horrors it tries to drown me under. Es kommt eine Pause, oder? Also, to be continued. Okay, ich krieg wieder Leben. Yay, kein Game Over erstmal! Let's go! Okay. Sie auch. So, Witness, please state your name and occupation for the court. Yujin Mikotoba, lecturer in forensic medicine at the Imperial Human University in Tokyo, Japan. And Professor Mikotoba, the young lady beside you is... Ah, this is Dr. Mariah Gorey. Scotland Yard's practicing coroner, the daughter of Dr. Scythe, I understand. Yes, Dr. Scythe. I'm afraid I can't tell you why she's here. She just appeared. You summoned a strange Japanese man as a witness to that autopsy. But you don't summon Mama. That makes no sense. She was there too. That's about the size of it. I felt her eyes boring into the side of my cheek constantly, whilst I was in the antechamber too. Poor man, the idea of it's making me shudder. The revelations about Dr. Scythe that came to light some days ago defiled the reputation of the entire judiciary. She was therefore deemed unfit to appear as a witness in today's proceedings. The Ministry of Justice's decision on that is final. Well, we wouldn't want any more perjury to be committed, would we? Also ihr glaube ich auch. Ich glaube nicht, dass sie lügt. Ich glaube, sie sagt wirklich die Wahrheit. The Ministry of Justice. Some questionable strings are being pulled, I think. I remember you, Dr. Mikotoba. But I certainly never expected to be meeting you under these circumstances. Yes, it's been a long while, Lord Strongheart. The prosecution understands that you were a visiting student of forensic science in London until 10 years ago. That's right. I studied under Dr. Wilson at St. Sinner's. So you were present at the autopsy of my brother, Lord Clint von Siegs. I was, yes. I assisted Dr. Wilson with the entire procedure.
Sir. Mama is far more skilled than any Japanese man.
Well, Dr. Wilson asked me to be his primary assistant on that occasion. And his autopsy report was actually penned by you, I believe. Yes, I noted all of the doctor's findings and when we were done, he read through the document and signed it.
Poor Mama. As secondary assistant, she wouldn't have had such a good view of all the innards.
So, Professor. Do you remember Inspector Gregson? Yes, of course. If it wasn't for his insistence, Lord von Sieg's autopsy would never have happened. But he was absolutely convinced that it would reveal decisive evidence against Genshin, you see.
So Lord Strongheart had to entreat the nobility to allow it to take place. Do correct me if I'm wrong, my lord. It was as a result of that autopsy that a mass murderer was apprehended and justice was done. But Gregson admitted it before he was killed. He admitted that the results of the autopsy were fabricated.
Weißt du da was darüber?
You were there at the time, so you must testify. You have an obligation to tell the truth about what really went on.
Absolutely. That's precisely why I'm here.
And that's why I'm here too?
Very well then. You will give your formal testimony now, witness. But before you begin, a word of warning.
Oh?
You will state truthfully and accurately what you saw and what you heard at the time.
I wouldn't dream of doing otherwise, my lord.
The moment your testimony verges on supposition, I will expel you from my courtroom. Remember that.
Okay. So, ich glaube, die können wir uns noch anhören. Angreifen werde ich erst beim nächsten Mal. Die Autopsie von Clint van Sieks.
From my own observations, I couldn't say there was any indication of the autopsy results having been fabricated.
Laut meinen eigenen Observationen, Beobachtungen, könnte ich nicht sagen, ob es irgendein Anzeichen darauf gab, dass der Autopsiebericht gefaked wurde in irgendeiner Form.
Death resulted from a wound made by a western-style sword transfixing the heart, that I found a little strange.
Wissen wir das überhaupt, was die Todesursache war? Fällt mir gerade auf. Doch, okay, wissen wir, ja. Also eine Stichwunde, okay. Ja, auf jeden Fall, genau, die Todesursache kam durch eine Wunde, die mit einem westlichen Schwert gemacht wurde, das durchs Herz ging. Und das fand ich etwas seltsam, sagt Miketoba.
There were no other signs of internal injury, nothing questionable at all.
Es gab keine anderen Spuren von inneren Verletzungen, nichts, was da irgendwie komisch dran sein würde.
It was just a beautiful but dangerous piece of evidence removed from the man's stomach.
Ja, was ist es denn? Es war nur, oder da im Inneren war nur dieses eine, oder dieser eine schöne, aber gefährliche Beweis, der dann aus dem Magen von dem Mann entfernt wurde.
Presumed to have been swallowed by the victim as a way of posthumously identifying his assailant.
Und es wurde angenommen, dass das Opfer diesen Beweis geschluckt hat, um nach seinem Tod dann seinen Attentäter identifizieren zu können.
No indication. Nothing to suggest fabrication.
Professor Miketoba, are you certain about that?
Well, nothing that I could positively identify as such, much less swear to it in testimony.
Ja, wir finden das trotzdem. Ist halt versteckt.
Well, that clears things up nicely. The only fabrication here, Azugi, has come from you.
What?
You claim the inspector confessed just before his death. But that is the fabrication.
No, he freely acknowledged it, I swear he did.
Freely, with the tip of a sword at his throat, the man was clearly at his wit's end. The court will give no credence to this confession that was uttered in obvious desperation.
Quite simply, there was nothing questionable about the investigation of Lord Clint van Sieks' death.
And with this testimony we have, without question, uncovered the whole truth of the matter.
Wir haben ein Recht auf Kreuzverhör, du Vollidiot.
If I may, my lord. There was most certainly something questionable about it, and the whole truth does rather elude us, I feel.
I beg your pardon.
Well, you're obviously aware of the facts of the case. All four of the professor's previous victims died when an enormous beast was set upon them that ripped out their throats.
Oh, such horrifying crimes.
But curiously, the killer's last victim, Lord Clint van Sieks, suffered a different fate.
Yes, you're right.
He was stabbed through the heart with a sword.
That's enough. I believe I warned you about this witness. I promised to curtail your testimony as soon as it entered the realms of supposition or speculation.
Very well, my lord. In that case, the defense will pursue a conclusion to this during the cross-examination.
What?
I have the right to cross-examine every witness after testimony. And I fully intend to exercise that right.
Ryunosuke.
I'm afraid that even the presiding judge has no authority to contravene the letter of the law, as I'm sure every member of the judiciary present in the gallery would agree.
Wie sie ständig Mikotoba anschaut, ist ja mega creepy.
Very well, you may begin, counsel. However, the moment your argument strays from the established facts, I will not hesitate to bring the cross-examination to an end. Proceed with caution.
Yes, my lord. Ist es nach 100 Jahren in Ace Attorney mal wieder so, dass ich nicht jedes Mal angreifen darf? Doch, ich glaube, ich darf immer angreifen. Und ich habe wieder 5 Leben, yay! Dann kann ich wieder ein bisschen mehr Blödsinn machen. So, ich würde aber dann erstmal sagen, das war's hier für diesen Part von Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles hier bei The Great Ace Attorney 2. Beim nächsten Mal werden wir dann die Aussage von Mikotoba und Gorill und auch von Seeks, die haben ja alle drei was abgegeben, der Aussage, angucken. Ein bisschen angreifen, ich werde schon angreifen dürfen und dann irgendwo was finden. Ich habe jetzt noch hier keinen Widerspruch bisher erkannt. Und Mikotoba hat ja auch quasi keinen Widerspruch erkannt, keinen gefälschten Beweis oder sonst irgendwas komisches bei dem Autopsiebericht, außer dass er anders gestorben ist. Aber auf jeden Fall nichts, was direkt darauf hindeuten würde, dass der Autopsiebericht gefälscht wurde. Das ist halt irgendwo versteckt. Ich weiß noch nicht wo, aber wir werden das schon ans Tageslicht bringen, hoffe ich. Gut, also dann Leute, bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.